So hello, today Kawasaki ZZ1000 motorcycle, spark plug replacement and air filter. No spark plug, sorry, over here. The air filter is going to be on the way. Now we have to start taking things apart. First seats off. There is a clip down here which you undo so you can release this. Release this bench. Okay. Seats off. The other seat comes off with the key. You insert it here. Now we have to take the fuel tank off. Obviously, all those plastics around here. Start removing plastics. Hex number 5. Turn the screws out. You can see this side popped off. Now we move to the other side and do the same thing. Now this plastic sits on the rubber bushings. Just pry it out carefully. This side there was a screw as well. And now we are good to. Now fuel tank 12 mm. Crack this open. Now once you got this fuel tank bolt loosened, you take this tank, lift it up and push forward carefully. Okay. So with the fuel tank, I didn't remove any hose. There is so much room. I set it at the side. But I can reach this spark plug, but the rest of the two are down here. Which means we have to take this coolant hoses and everything off. The thermostat or what is sitting here. In order to remove this whole bracket, because the one is down there and the other spark plug is down deep here. So in order to remove this thermostat housing, I decided that I take this blinker off. There's a connection and 3 number 6 hex bolts holding it. Set it somewhere aside. Now my plan is simple. In order to reach those spark plugs, I'm taking this coolant hose off from here, clamping it off, and one from here. So my plan is then I possibly can lift this coolant reservoir up, or where you fill that coolant, this part, and then I should be able to reach those two spark plugs, which is in the middle here. So what I decided to do, to take one coolant hose off from this radiator. Then I moved clamp from here. Plan is to simply to lift this coolant refill reservoir up so I can gain the access. In order to do that, there is ground wires bolted down here. Take this bolt off. This bracket bolt you actually don't have to undo. You do this and this whole unit starts moving. Now we can lift this probably up from away. And then we should be good to go. Let me see. Okay. It's coming off. Very nice. Let's see. Will it come past this wiring harness? Now, once you got this unit removed, I'm taking this final ground off from here as well, so we can take this part away. Ground wires I'm going to clean later. So I sit this somewhere here aside so I don't step on it. And now we should be able to reach spark plugs. Let me see when it's fast like this. Those three I can reach pretty easy. This one. There's wires on way. You can move them side to side in order to reach this spark plug. So now, let's start changing them. There is some wire in the way. Press this button down. Start taking the connections off from coils. Set them aside, away from here. Now you should be able to move. So I turn this coil this side, take the flat screwdriver, put this between this plastic and very easily pry. Do not force it, it will break. We don't want to break it. And this coil is out. Set this aside. Now the spark plug sits deep down there. I have made the extension to feed in. This is a 16mm. 16. Place it in. Sits in. A little wrench. Oh, let's crack it loose and see. It's loose. Already loose. Okay. And those spark plugs go in pretty much with no torque. 13Nm only. So be very careful if you start putting the new ones in. Use the torque wrench. Let's see. Can I get this out from here? Hands with coolant, slippery. And it's free, I think. Yes, spark plug comes out. Not bad, but definitely haven't been changed before. We have a brand new engine keys. These are iridium. Those old ones are Denso, and also iridium. Okay. And now, once the old spark plug is out, I take the new one. But there is a grease. Put a little bit grease there. This is a special made for spark plugs, in order to in future to get them out, so they don't rust into this plug. I'm going to put this grease a little bit here and then take a torque wrench, torque them down, 13Nm. That's the proper way, almost nothing. So it's like a finger or half tight, something like that. Now once you put the ITCs on the threads, take the spark plug, the new one, feed it carefully in. You feel that it started threading. Now take this torque wrench, set it up to 13Nm. Feed it in, let's see. You can see it's torqued on, and then we can move it onto the other spark plug. Did it went in. Yes, it's in. In order to pop this coil back out, long screwdriver, place it between the screw, help with finger and pressure a little bit, and it comes out. As you can see. So bigger extension did not fit, so I made this kind of set off. This is a 3/8 into 1/2 socket. And I have this kind of setup in order to reach this spark plug. Now you can see it goes nicely past it. Will it bottom out? We'll see. I had to use a longer socket in order to take out, not the right spark plug one. I'm using this magnet to pull this out. As you can see, the old spark plug is over here. Turn this way. And it came loose. Now, try to wiggle the coil out. Yes, there are cables everywhere. It's a bit tricky, but it will run. It's old, old Soviet era screwdriver. And it came out nicely. Now that's it, all the spark plugs have been replaced. Connect these coil packs. This wiring connections back. Each one where it belongs. Click. Now take this coolant filling pipe unit. Feed this bigger pipe back to radiator side where it has to go. Little bit playing. Make sure you don't break any hoses and stuff like that on the way. I mean electrical connections. Now once you got this coolant hose fed through, make sure you seat it, this one properly as well. Rolling the clamp a little bit down so I don't lose it. Now this is in place. Check that everything, anything isn't rubbing and we'll be good to go. Refill your coolant. Once you got all the hoses and stuff connected. I'm not sure how much came out it, we'll see. Now stop. Now once spark plugs are done, you change the air filter as well. You have to remove this bracket. And then the air filter housing sits here with the screws. Two screws I think I see. So take this out. Play with it a little bit. The arm behind here and it came off. The air filter sits inside here. New filter. Once you blasted all the dirt away with the pressure here and it sits in. Take this plastic cap, there's air which has to go into the slot back there. Try to wiggle it back in. And that's it. Pretty much screw and bolt everything together. Then put this gas tank back. All the seats, all those plastics which I took off. You actually don't have to take those off, which are in here, in order to do spark plugs. And that's it. Thanks for watching. Subscribe, like, and comment down below.